San Francisco, amen. And so he knew I was coming, and he made us feel welcome by the 49. I know you. So what do we have here? Raider fans? Is that what it is? Raider. No, he said no. What do you got, brother? Come. Oh, he's at Buffalo, brother. You're in the wrong city, brother. Come on. I got a pastor friend of mine that lives over here in Temecula. When everybody's screaming for the Raiders and the 49ers, he's screaming for Pittsburgh. I'm like, dude, you need to go back east. Come on, somebody. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. All right. So is everybody ready to have a good time in Jesus? Amen. Well, I'll tell you what, before we start any of my original music, let's just start off with a worship song. Is that all right? If I can get you guys to get on your feet and help me out by putting your hands together like this. Come on. Here we go.
Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of the King rise among us. Let it rise. Let it rise. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of the King rise among us. Let it rise. Let it rise.
Somebody sing, oh!
Oh, oh, let it rise.
One more time, nice and loud. Somebody sing, oh!
Oh,
come on.
Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord
come on
rise among us. Let the praises of the King rise among us. Let it rise. Let it rise.
Father God, in Jesus' mighty name, I pray that you meet every need for every person that is here today. Bless them mentally, bless them physically, bless them financially. If you agree with that, can I get a good amen?
Let the glory of the Lord
what?
Rise among us. Let the glory.
The most blessed person here today to make some noise for Jesus. Come on. If you're too blessed to be stressed, make some noise. I know you can do better than that. Amen. Amen. Make some noise. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity of being here today, Lord. I just give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 So we've had a fabulous few days ministering with Brother Sal Amen. He set up some wonderful opportunities for us to come out here and minister. Amen. Amen. And it looks like it's going to be the start of something pretty awesome. Amen. And brother, let's give a round of applause for this husband and wife team. So powerful. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And let's see what's going on here. Okay, there you go. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And as Pastor Rudy was saying, and as Brother Sal was saying, I used to sing with a group. In 1998, while on tour in Denver, Colorado, after recording a live concert, I went back to the promoter's house. And as I used to do many, many times, I was just caught up abusing my body with whatever I can get my hands on. And this particular night, I was caught up smoking crack cocaine. But see, this night was different from any other night that I used to get high. You see, because whenever I used to get high in the past, I would stay awake for 2-3 days at a time chasing the dragon. Amen. You know what that means? Chasing the dragon, trying to reproduce that first hit of the pipe. And I was and I was like, okay, let's go. And matter of fact, I was getting high with one of the Denver Broncos at the time. Amen. Uh-oh. And I won't mention his name because it's not about putting anyone on blast, but it's just a fact. Amen. And so what ended up happening was I overdosed. My heart stopped. Amen. My heart stopped. And I remember waking up, just opening my eyes the next morning, and I'm laying on the floor not knowing what just happened to me. And as I gained my composure, I sat down on the couch of the promoter, and I started looking around, and I said, what just happened to me? And I noticed there was a television sitting right at my reach, and I leaned over and I turned it on, and there's something that I've never seen in my life. There was a lady on TV preaching, and I never knew there was such thing as women preachers. Come on, somebody, in Jesus' name. But she was saying things that was hitting me in the corazón. How many know what corazón means? It means the heart. She was saying things to me like, are you up to no good? She went on to say, she says, do you have a spouse at home that loves you? Then she said, do you have kids at home that love you? Then she said one thing that got my attention. She said, do you just want to know that you have those kids, or do you want to be able to raise them? You see, I knew what she was talking about, because where I grew up in the San Francisco housing projects, exactly where Pastor, amen, where I grew up in the Army Street projects, 75% of my friends didn't have father figures in their life, amen, including me at the time. And so I knew what she was talking about, raising the kids. She went on to say that God had a magnificent plan for my life. She went on to say that God had me at a crossroad, and he was asking me to make a decision whether to continue down the path of destruction that I was on or to receive a new life that was more abundant, amen. 15 minutes time, this evangelist TV preacher by the name of Joyce Meyer had me on my hands and knees, and she was leading me through a sinner's prayer. Amen. I ended up receiving the Lord in the promoter's living room after waking up from an overdose. I went to find the promoter, and I said, you got to take me to the airport. I said, I don't want to play this music anymore. I said, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but I know that I'm not supposed to do this anymore. So I went home. And while I was on the airplane, the Lord said, I want you to confess to your wife everything that you've done behind her back. And I said, uh-oh. I said, wait a minute, I didn't sign up for this. I said, uh-oh. So I finally got home, and I walked through the door, and my wife says, what are you doing home so early? She says, I thought you were on tour. And I said, sit down, I have to tell you something. She looked at me, and without skipping a beat, she goes like this. She says, you're not going to tell me that you found God, are you? I said, as a matter of fact, I am. I said, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but I don't want to go back to secular music. And she said, whatever you decide, I'm 100% behind you. Amen. So I started looking through the yellow pages. See, you kids today, you don't know what the yellow pages are because they don't have them no more. But Pastor, I started looking through the yellow pages because I didn't want to go back to where I came from, my upbringing. I didn't want to go back to the kind of church life that I used to go to when I used to go to church just for Easter and Christmas and Thanksgiving. Come on, somebody. Amen. So I found a non-denominational Christian church in my town of Hercules where I started attending. I went to the church service for the first time. And when I walked into this building, there's something that I've never heard before. I've never heard music that sounds so contemporary, music that was honoring our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Because the kind of church that I used to go to, they used to play a lot of chamber music. But I never knew that God's music can sound just like it sounded today on this stage. Amen. Praise God. So before the service was over, they did an altar call. And I went up to the front altar and I got on my knees. And the pastor put his hand on my shoulder. And as soon as he put his hand on my shoulder, my body started shaking. And I felt like somebody pulled the cork out of the bottom of my shoe and my whole spirit got flushed. And in Jesus' name, I got filled with a new spirit right there on the spot. Amen. I started crying like a little baby. I said, I don't deserve this. And I looked at the pastor and I said, I don't deserve this. He said, son, nobody deserves it. Just receive it. Amen. So I did. As I'm laying there, fetal position on the ground, I'm shaking and I'm crying. And I said, Lord, whatever you want to do with me, I don't care if I clean the bathrooms. I don't care if I vacuum the church. Whatever you want to do with me, just use me. And the Lord says, I'm not going to take you out of the music. I'm just going to give you a new song to sing. Come on, somebody. In Jesus' mighty name. So the Lord put me on a fast track to ministry. And I went back to Malo Music and I asked them permission if I could reproduce the song that they made famous. How many know the song Malo made famous? Amen. Called Suavecito. How many remember Suavecito? I went back to Malo Music and I said, will you give me permission to reproduce this song as a gospel hymn? So today, ladies and gentlemen, I bless you. Is that okay? Stand on your feet and join me as I bless you with this song. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Here we go.
Right to testify, the time is right. to get sanctified. No matter what,
no matter what,
you've done it live. Surrender it all to Jesus. All I want is you. If I can't have you, I don't know what to do.
If you know the song, sing along.
La la la, la la la.
Sing.
La la la, la la la, la la la.
Father God, in Jesus' name, I pray that you bless Faith Center, Pastor Rudy, and all the congregation. Father God, keep your hand on them and meet their needs mentally, physically, and financially. If you just need that, somebody give me a good amen. Somebody give me a good amen. Hallelujah. Uh-oh, sounds like Marlo's in the house. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Here we go. Put your hands together. To celebrate with Jesus. Is that all right? If you're not ashamed of Jesus Christ, make some noise. Come on. Here we go.
Now that I'm dancing in the
say, feel the power. Here we go.
Felt this before.
Sing.
See me running through that open door. Keep
ha 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 ha. Reggae, 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 ding, ding, ding.
Bless you. How many feel the power of God? Come on, somebody. In Jesus' mighty name. Praise you, Lord. So I want to share a quick little story with you. Many years ago, when my middle son was 23 years old, he contracted a condition in his body called lupus. How many know what lupus is? He had the most severe case of lupus. You see, he ended up losing both of his kidneys. At 23 years old, he lost function of both of his kidneys. So for 7 years, my son had to go and hook himself up to a machine at a dialysis clinic. And he would have to filter his blood 4 hours a day, 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And after 7 years, my wife went to pick up my son at the dialysis clinic, and while they were on their way home on the freeway, he opened up the door and tried to jump out. You see, he didn't want to live no more. He says, this is not the life of a young man. He said, all my friends are getting married. All my friends got jobs. All my friends got girlfriends. What am I doing? I'm stuck to a machine. I'm stuck to an iron kidney. I'm stuck to a machine that's filtering my blood. I can't do nothing. After I do dialysis, I go home and sleep because I'm so wiped out. So he tried to commit suicide and jump out the car. My wife called me on the phone and she was crying and she said, you need to come home right away. So when I got home, I can hear my wife crying upstairs in our bedroom. And I went upstairs and I walked inside the door and there she is on her hands and knees and she's crying to God. And she said, Lord, if you're not going to bless my son and heal him, take him now. Just take him. And I said, wait a minute. What do you mean take him? God ain't taking him nowhere. We don't serve a God of defeat. We serve a God of second chance, restoration. We serve a God... Come on, how many know that God is still in the miracle business? Come on, somebody. I said, get off your feet. We started changing the way we prayed. We started saying, thank you, Lord, for giving him a second chance. Thank you, Lord, for restoring his life. Thank you, Lord, for blessing him with a new kidney. Thank you, Lord, for... And we started speaking healing into his life. How many know that the Bible says, speak things into existence as if they are, even if they're yet not? Amen? So I left the bedroom and I went downstairs and I sat down at my piano and I started playing some chords and I started crying because the truth of the matter is I didn't even know how to pray for my wife. I didn't know what to say to my wife. I was just as scared as she was. And I started crying to God and I said, Lord, please send me an angel because I don't know how to pray. Send me an angel to wrap his arms around me and comfort me and encourage me and tell me how to pray. So out of that cry and out of that prayer request came one of our most requested songs. And right now I'm going to have my wife come up and join me. Come on. Come on. Up here. She wasn't prepared for this, but how many know that God says you got to be ready in season and out of season? Come on. Up there, right in the middle. So while my son was going into dialysis for 7 years, they were treating his lupus like they treat cancer. He was getting chemotherapy. He was getting blood transfusion. He was taking all these different pills. He was taking over 30 pills a day. Do the math. How many pills was he taking in a month? Hundreds. The doctor said, because of all the medication that we pumped in your body, you can no longer have children. You will never have a child. Because of all the medicine, he couldn't have children. But how many know that the devil is a liar? Come on, somebody. How many know that we serve a God that's still in the miracle business? We received a phone call from UC Medical Center. They asked my wife to come to the hospital to be tested. She went to the hospital. They tested her. She was 100% match. I'm here to tell you today that my wife gave birth to my son 2 times because she donated one of her kidneys to my son, and now my son is living a healthy life. Come on, somebody. And the icing on the cake is that we just celebrated my son's baby's birthday. Come on. He had a child. God is still in the miracle business. If you've been praying for something and you say, God, you're not answering my prayer, just wait. It's God's timing, amen? It's not our timing. It's God's timing, amen? It took him 7 years to receive that kidney. Don't give up. I always tell people that when you're going through a situation, it's like stepping into a boxing ring. Sometimes you'll get a knockout punch in the first round, but sometimes you're going to have to go 10 rounds. Come on, somebody. Amen. So out of that prayer and out of that cry came this song, and it goes a little something like this. Going like this. Check it out. Juan, where you at? My Lord, would you send me an angel? Would you send me an angel to pray with me? My Lord, would you ask them to hold me? Would you have them to hold me and pray with me?
Guitar.
I call your name. My Lord, teach me to pray. Down on my knees I say, Lord, would you send me an angel? Would you send me an angel to pray? A gentle round of applause for my beautiful wife, Lonnie Cantu. Lord, I
teach me to pray. Down on my knees I say, Lord, would you send me an angel? Lord, please send me an angel to pray with me.
Somebody sing, pray with me.
Pray with me.
Well, I'm reaching out to you.
Pray with me.
I need your help.
Pray with me.
Yeah, my Lord.
Pray with me. Pray with me.
Hallelujah. Thank you, my love. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I think my iPad overheated. I think the radiator's broken on my iPad. Orale. Praise. It's cooling down? Oh, it's cooling down. Okay. Oh, yeah. It says temperature. Yes, ma'am. Are you ready?
You want to do that?
Amen. We could try.
Hallelujah. So let me share my side of the story. But I was having a pity party. Does anybody else have pity parties? Right? God allows you to go through that, right? Some of you may be thinking, why did it take 7 years to, you know, find out if your son was, you know, compatible to my, you know, kidney? The early times, when we found out he had lupus, they did test me. But for some odd reason, his antibodies were rejecting mine. And we couldn't understand, maybe because the lupus was active or there's just other underlying issues that were going on with him. But I believe that 7 year journey God used to draw closer to him, not just for me, but for my son too. You have to know that my son, who believed in Jesus Christ, but didn't have a relationship with him. So he used that time to draw near and to know God. God could give you that instant miracle, right? Yes. But I believe there's also a process miracle. For some of you, some people that have that instant miracle, the next day or a couple days, they can forget about that miracle easily. But when you work through that process and that miracle, you hold on to it, and when you wake up every single morning and thank God for it and so grateful. Amen?
Amen.
So for some of you, please don't give up. Prayer is powerful. We never know what God is doing behind the scenes, but he is always working behind the scenes on our behalf. Amen? So please don't give up. Prayer is powerful. We are living proof. There's so many things that happen in our life, tragedies. We lost our daughter 2 years ago. She got hit by a car. And then my son, years before that, our older son, tried to commit suicide. It's like people look at us and say, you know, you guys are out there ministering and serving the Lord. You know, how could those things happen to you? Why not us? The more we serve the Lord, the enemy tries hard to attack, and he wants to bring you down. He wants you to give up. But it only made us stronger. Our faith is even stronger than today. Nothing can bring us down now. We only strive better to be with the Lord. Yesterday, Martin had shared a testimony about our good friend. His best friend had passed away a couple days ago. And I heard my husband, when he found out about it, he was in a shower. He was sobbing. And then when he got out, I said, what's going on? Just share with me. And he said, I just asked the Lord, why? Why? And he felt the Lord pressed upon his heart. Why ask why? He said, I just need you to be ready, to prepare yourself. And your job is to prepare others. Because one day we will all be with him, and that is our ultimate goal of this earth, is to get everybody ready and prepared to be with our Lord Jesus Christ. You can't tell me there's no God. There's a God. I've seen too many miracles, even more tragedies than I've seen. The miracles overpower. Amen? Don't give up. Stay strong and stay faithful.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. Yeah, it is getting a little warm out here. It's time for me to put on my cachucha.
Orale.
Come on, somebody. And Jesus, is that ready to go? If not, we can do this. Plug that in right there. Praise God, praise God. There's a song that's coming off this our new CD, and I want to bless you with it. I was going to do it last night, but we ran out of time. But I pray this song blesses your heart. If it doesn't, I guess. Looking towards tomorrow with my eyes on the sun, living the wrong life, searching for someone. But God had the answer all of the time. His grace and forgiveness bless me with forgiveness in this heart of mine. Oh, this heart of mine. What seemed like forever, my heart was so hard while living the wrong life. I prayed a new start, but God had the answer. The time, His grace and forgiveness, He blessed me with forgiveness in this heart of mine. Oh, this heart of mine. Oh, this heart of mine.
How many know that God can change your heart on an instant? He's just looking for you to step out of your comfort zone and say, Lord, I believe and I receive in Jesus' name.
Sins were forgiven in this heart of mine.
This heart, that
heart, this heart. Oh, this heart of mine.
This heart, that heart, this heart.
With His love divine.
This heart, that heart, this heart.
Oh, this heart of mine.
Let's give the Lord a mighty round of applause. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be able to share the gifts that you've given us, Father God, the talents. Brother Sal, you guys are just so awesome. How about a husband and wife team? Come on, somebody. You don't see that no more. Amen. I tell people all the time that when I was running with the world and I was running around the world there with Malo, and you know, I was up to no good. I was living the life of sex, drugs, and rock and roll. But now I get to travel the world with my beautiful wife. Amen. Praise God. And we can minister together. So that's an awesome thing you guys are doing. Praise God. Hallelujah. We're going to bless you with a song that goes like this. The band can follow if you guys want to join in. And it goes a little something like this. Check this one out.
Orale.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
Here we go.
Da, 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 da.
Jesus, hallelujah.
I want to share a little something with you. This song here that we ministered a few minutes ago, it just speaks to my heart, because I believe no matter what situation that you are in, I believe it that if you cry out to God, I believe that He will answer your prayers. Amen? Can I get you to all stand on your feet? Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, there was a time when I was in Denver, Colorado, and when I was up to no good and I was smoking crack and I overdosed, did you know that God came and found me? I didn't even have to wear a suit. I didn't even have to take a shower. I didn't even have to brush my teeth. God came and found me in the condition that I was at. Amen? God wants to do the same for every one of you here today. I know there's a lot of you here that have received Jesus Christ into your heart as Lord and Savior, but I also know that there's some of you who have ran away from God. Some of you have maybe backslid, or some of you perhaps never received Jesus Christ as your heart, as your Lord and Savior. If I can get you to stand to your feet, if you're able, please stand to your feet. I believe God wants to touch you right now. I believe God wants to transition something into your life that's going to go on to become a ministry. Amen. I believe that God is going to answer that prayer that you've been petitioning Him day and night, night and day. Amen. And right now is going to be your moment. In Jesus' name, I pray. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. I want you to get yourself in the attitude of worship and just usher in the Holy Spirit.
In the presence of sweet Jesus, who is God Almighty. He's the Prince of Peace. Troubles vanish, hearts are mended in the
right now. I want you guys to get out of your seat. I want you to come join me right here. I want you to do social distancing. Give yourself enough room. But I want you guys to come up to the altar. Come on. Come on. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, brother. Come on. Hallelujah. If you're able, come up to the altar. Come on.
Troubles vanish. Hearts are mended in the presence of the King.
Start lifting up your voices and talking to God. I want you to start petitioning God. Tell Him your prayer request. Ask Him to answer your prayers. Ask Him to touch your life, touch your family, touch your children, touch your husband, touch your wife. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, reign. Holy Spirit, reign.
Troubles vanish. Hearts are mended.
King. In the presence of the King.
I want you to stay in the attitude of worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father God, right now we just usher in your Holy Spirit. You know the need of every single person that's here today, Father God. I remember when I was a no good for nothing, lying, cheat, drug addict. You came and found me right where I was at. And I believe right now, Father God, as your word says, where two or three are gathered, that you are in the midst. I pray in Jesus' mighty name, Father God, right now that you're sending down angels to meet the prayer request of all your children, Father God. Lift your hands in the air right now. Lift your hands in the air. I tell people all the time, the reason we lift our hands in the air, it's the same thing as, I don't know if some of you have ever been arrested. I've been arrested when I was younger and running in the world. And the police would tell me, put your hands up. I would put my hands up to surrender. That's why we lift our hands in the air, to surrender to God. Amen. But today is your day. Today is the day that you say, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. Everything that I've tried never seemed to work. So, Lord, today I surrender my life unto you. You see, I tell people all the time, imagine that Jesus is in the back seat of your car and you're steering the wheel. The Lord said, I can't do anything for you until you surrender 100%. What we need to do today is switch places. Let Jesus steer the wheel. Amen. And you sit in the back seat of the car. Some of you might be here and say, you know what? I've already received the Lord into my heart, Lord and Savior, but I want to stand in the gap for my family. I want to stand in the gap for my husband, my wife, my children. I want to stand in the gap. If that's you, I want you to just stand up and come and join us up here at the altar. Amen. Pastor Rudy, do we have any prayer warriors with you that are with your team? Amen. If I can get maybe one or two ladies to go over to the senior, you don't have to lay hands on them, but just stay in the distance and pray over them. Amen. Sister Kim, can you go over there and just stretch your hands towards them and pray for them? Amen. Hallelujah. If you've never received Jesus Christ into your heart as Lord and Savior, today's your day. If you backslid and said, Pastor Martin, I want to rebuild a relationship with the Lord. I need a fresh beginning. I need a fresh start. I need to hit the reset button. Amen. Every head bowed, nobody looking around. Put your hands in the air. Every head bowed, nobody looking around. Put your hands in the air.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
If this is you, check. Then this day is for you.
Check. Check. Check.
I want you to repeat after me. Say, Father God,
Father God,
forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
If there's anything that I've said,
that I've done,
that I thought, that's unpleasing to you, forgive me. I believe Jesus Christ was crucified. He was murdered. He was buried. And he rose on the third day. Now sits at the right hand side of God. Today I profess and confess. I proclaim. I receive Jesus Christ into my heart as my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Let's give the Lord a mighty round of applause. Amen. Usually I like to come over and lay hands on you, but because of the whole social distancing, we just want to comply. Amen. The Bible says to give Caesar what is Caesar's and give to God what is God. So we're complying. Amen. But as Pastor Rudy said, God said, I could do whatever I want to do. Come on, somebody. God said, I'm bigger than the government. Amen. I'm bigger than the authority here in the city. But you see, we still comply. because we love you that much. We don't want you to get sick. We don't want to get sick, so we comply. But how many know that the Holy Spirit is here and he wants to transform your life forever? Amen. Pastor Rudy, would you like to close out?